Shaken baby syndrome is probably one of the most, if not the most, difficult things that we deal with as pediatricians. You know, you have these very vulnerable young infants who, for one reason or another, have put themselves into harm's way and injuries that inflicted onto them by one of their caregivers. You know, the babies are susceptible to injury for several reasons. Most of it has to do with the very large size of their heads and very poor head control. That large size, poor muscle control, so there's going to be a lot of forces, any shaking is going to lead to a tremendous amount of force within the head of the kids. But it really takes a fairly significant shaking and force to create that injury. It's not going to happen with just your playful bouncing on the knee, or, you know, a lot of kids, once they do get some head control, you'll see them being tossed up in the air and caught in kind of a playful manner. Those types of things are not going to create a shaken baby syndrome. These are truly inflicted, typically out of anger, pretty violent events. There can be a variety of symptoms, but the main symptom that children present with shaken baby syndrome is seizures. So a young child, typically somewhere 3 to 6 months of age, will present to a medical facility having had seizures. The other issue would be apnea, or just the stoppage of breathing, or just an incredibly fussy, irritable, unexplained irritability. Anywhere from 15 to 25% of cases end in death. So this is a cause of death in young infants in this age group. The ones that are fortunate enough to survive end up with long-term neurological problems, often blindness, sometimes some hearing deficits, learning disabilities, permanent seizure disorder. A lot of them really fail to achieve their normal neurological milestones that you would expect your average toddler and kid to achieve. I don't bring it up directly with many families, but if I do have a baby who is extremely colicky and extremely fussy baby, I do make sure I have a one-on-one conversation with those parents to make sure that they understand these are the kids that put themselves at risk. And none of us think we'll be the perpetrator, but we all have a breaking point. We all have those thresholds. So you've got to know your own limitations. You've got to not be afraid to go get help. Accept and admit when you're at your end and you need that help before you do something foolish.